Hello everyone, my name is Anish Rana and today topic is ETCD backup and restore. In next 6 minutes, I will walk you through the steps how to create ETCD snapshot and how to restore it. So let's begin. Let's go to the lab number 2. Lab for taking snapshot. Here the question is, create a snapshot for existing ETCD instance running on this local host. Port number is 2379. Saving the snapshot to varlib etcd snapshot.db file. Next, restore an existing previous snapshot located at this previous DB file. It means that first we need to create the lab here. So this time I'm going to use this command here so that I can create one snapshot. Now the lab is created here. I go to here. Let me open a new tab here and go to here. Click on documentation. Write etcdd. Click here, the first link. If I scroll down, here you will observe the title backing up etcd cluster. If you scroll down, now you will observe this command is here. Either you can use this command here, etcd ctl underscore api equal to 3. It's a version 3. And you will observe that endpoint is showing 127.0.23 and ca.crt file. You need to be fine. How you can find this? Now I need to find all these details here. How can I do here? I can open this file. It's a static YAML file of etcd. If I scroll up, I will observe all these details here. Server crt file is here. Key listen. Listen client URL is here, server key file is this, and then trusted CA file is this. I need to copy all these things here. Like here, and then snapshot, save, and then one new file location. This is what it is given in the question, that I need to save in this file, varlib etcd snapshot.db file here. Let me copy this command here. Here you will observe that I use the same command that is mentioned in the Kubernetes documentation. Or either I can use here kubectl minus n kube hyphen system describe pods etcd. The same thing, you will observe all these details here. Same thing inside this command section. Now I'm going to execute this command here. From the output, it says that snapshot is saved in this file here. I can list this file. If this file is created successfully, I can see this file here. Okay, let me clear the window. How to restore it? So let's assume that etcd data directory is corrupted. In this case, we need to restore the snapshot. Data directory is the directory where all the etcd configuration and data files are present. How we can check this thing? Again, from the YAML file, we can use data dir. So this is my data directory here. Let me show you here. This is the directory. D stands for directory. As per the question, a previous taken snapshot, etcd snapshot previous.db. Thus, we have to restore it from the file only. And please note that while restoring the snapshot, we have to use new data directory. Why? Because the previous directory is corrupted, and in the exam or in this question, it is asked to restore. If you use the same data directory, it will produce you error message. Why? Because this directory is already having some files. So when you're going to restore it, it will prompt you error. For that reason, we have to create a new directory every time whenever we are restoring it. Let me copy here. Snapshot restore and then the restore file name. It says it created here. Now we can examine directory, both directory previous and new one. This is my new directory and this is my previous data directory. And here both directory, the user is root and the group is root. But in exam, it might be different for you. For that reason, you can use ch own minus capital R. Ch own means change ownership, minus R is stands for recursive, and etcd etcd. This command you need to execute from sudo privileges, and then sudo systemctl start etcd, you can execute this command. Here I do not have the etcd separate server, so this service I haven't created in my environment. That's it, and the question is complete. Now it's time to deep dive into etcd snapshot and restore process. Hence, start with theory part. Etcd snapshot and backup. First, we are going to understand the basic of etcd, and then we will going to install the etcd package, how to create etcd snapshot, how to restore from the snapshot, and in the end we will do lab and exam preparation. So let's start with our first topic, that is understanding the basic of etcd database. Etcd is the etcd is the database server. It run on kube-system namespace. If I execute this command kubectl get pod minus a, it means all namespace. It means all namespace. You will observe that namespace is kube-system, and the name is this etcd master1.example.com. Etcd pod is static pod, and it run on pod number 2379. Basic information is this. As I said previously, etcd is the static pod. Thus, the YAML file of this pod should lies inside this Kubernetes directory, that is etc Kubernetes manifest. And if you open this file, you will observe inside this command there are too many options are there. The first thing is endpoints that we're going to explore. It means that etcd is reaching on which IP address and on which port number. By default, the port number is 2379. This is the official port number of etcd database server. The other thing is that server cert file, and then key file, and then ca.cert file that we need to use while taking the snapshot or restoring the database of etcd. If I zoom this file, I will observe that cert is this file, cert file is this, key file is this, listen on client URL, look at this 2379, and in the end, trust-ca file, ca.cert file. This is my cert file, this is my key file, this is my endpoints. Remember this port number 2379. And in the end, it is cert.ca file. Inside this file, you will also observe --- data equal to dir. This option informs us that all etcd configuration and its data file will be located on this directory. In short, we can say that this is the main directory where we will going where we will get all the information of the etcd database server. By default, this is the directory, but you can change it while creating the etcd server. If you check the directory in this file, you will observe that this directory also mount in the etcd pod, mount path and path number. Here I grab var lib etcd d. For information, I just copied here. You will observe that mount path is this and path is here. Inside this host path, it means that this will be mounted on the node itself. Same thing we can achieve if we execute the command kubectl get minus n kube hyphen system namespace describe subcommand and then port etcd master 1.example.com. This is the port name. It's up to you if you want to execute this command or you want to open the etcd static YAML file. All these options are available here. But in an exam, you can use this command, or if you want, you can use static file. It's up to you. Okay, so let's move forward. Now we understand the basic thing of etcdd, where is the file and where we can get all this information. Let's, by default, when you have Kubernetes cluster, etcdd package will be not available. Thus, you have to install that package. You can check by executing the command etcdd ctl version. If you observe some output, it means that this package is already installed. Maybe you can check in your office server. If it's not installed, then you need to execute this command. If it's not installed, then you can install with the help of GitHub page. You can download with the help of curl command. Then extract this directory and go inside this directory and then move all files which are starting with etcdd and then paste it over your local bin directory. After that, if you go outside, you can execute etcd ctl version. You will observe this output. It means that not exactly this output, but the latest version. When I'm not sure when you are going to watch this video, but the latest release you will be observed in the output here. Once this package is installed, you can execute etcdd space snapshot and then press enter. You will observe some output here. The first thing is status. It gets the backend snapshot status of a given file. After that, save. If you execute this command kube etcdd snapshot save and then file name, it will store an etcd node backend snapshot to this file. And the last one is restore. Obviously, whenever we are taking the backup, sometime we need to restore it. So it restore an etcd member snapshot to an etcd directory. And here you will also observe ca.cert file, cert, endpoints, all this information. Let's move ahead and check how to create the etcd snapshot. For this, you can log in into the kubernetes.io webpage. You can open and then search etcdd and then scroll down. You will observe this command. In exam, you will do same as it is what I am telling you. Open the webpage of kubernetes.io. In exam, it is allowed. Then search here etcdd and in the backup section, if you scroll down, you will observe the backup section and then you will observe this command. Just copy all this command and paste it into the notepad and modify these value ca.cert file, key file, and then snapshot save and then file name. Whatever you want to create the file, it will be asked in the question, or if you are in office, then obviously you have to take care of that. Remember that we have this output, right? Cert is this file, key is this file, and endpoint is this, and ca.cert file is this. Or maybe you can remember like ca, it come here, ca, and endpoints, how you can learn 2379 port number, okay, this is the port number, so this is the line, and key file is here, you will can check that this is server key, and for cert, you can see that cert file is here. This is how you can remember. I remember like this in my exam. And when we executing the command for taking the snapshot save, for taking the snapshot, you just copy paste from the Kubernetes web page and append these value, append the file name and press enter. You will observe the successful of snapshot. Now next is how to restore from the snapshot. We have taken the snapshot. Let's suppose that my data directory is corrupted where all the files are located and my etc pod or server is not working. Then obviously we have to restore from the snapshot. The good thing is that all the options are same. Instead of snapshot save, we use snapshot restore and then file name that we will create in the previous step, right? Apart from this, we have to give the new directory name, that is data directory name. The reason behind is that data directory is the etcd configuration directory. When we try to use the old one, it throw an error. You can remind this like whenever we restore the backup, we must use new directory. Okay. And the last is lab and exam preparations. In order to proceed the lab, I have already logged in into my GitHub page. And here I need to click on repository and click on Kubernetes. If I scroll down, I need to click on 18 etcd snapshot and restore. Here we have three labs. So let's proceed with the first one, that is lab one. And this lab is for taking etcd snapshot, restore, and then we will validate it. First, we are going to create a new pod so that we can validate our restore processes. Let me copy this command here and paste it over here. Let's check if this pod is created well or not. Minus W is for watch. Container creating. Now it is running. So let me Control C press. Let me press Control C. And then how to install etcd package. First, I'm going to check if my package is installed or not. For that reason, I'm just using kubectl, sorry, etcd ctl version, and it says command not found. It means that in my environment, etcd control package is not here, so I need to install it. This is the YAML file I'm going to download from the GitHub page. And after that, I need to extract the file. Let's check what file it is created here. It is created this one. It says V version star. Let me clear the window here and then a new directory is created here, etcd. Now I need to go inside this directory and then sudo. If you're not logging into the by root user, then you can use sudo. Let me copy in this way. Here, I extracted this file here and then copy all the etcd binary files inside this local. Now, I'm at root label. Let me show you pwd command here. I'm in root directory. version. Now it is, so I exported the path and now I can see that my etcd version is here. Let's proceed further. I will add this path also. So let's take the snapshot now. For this, I need to open this file here. Let me open this static etcd port YAML file here. And if I scroll up, I will observe all these details are here. Cert file is here. Data file is here, data DIR. And then key file is here, server.key, lesson client URL. It is lesson on 2379. So this is my endpoints. And trusted CA file is here. Okay. And the same thing I can observe here. If I use kubectl get pods minus capital A for all namespace, I will observe kubes hyphen system namespace. Inside this namespace, we have etcd pod here. Kubectl minus n namespace and then describe pods etc. If I scroll up, I will observe all these details. In exam, either you can open the YAML file or you can use describe subcommand. Now I'm going to copy this file here. Endpoints are there, CA cert file is this. And here, snapshot, save, and then a new file name. Here I'm going to create a new file that is inside this varlib directory. Let me copy this command here and paste it over here. From the output, it says snapshot save. Is save here. Now again, we can create a new pod. After the creating the snapshot, we are going to create a one new pod. And once we restore, this pod should not be available, right? Let me create a new pod here. So it's a post check. Ideally, it's not a post check, but yes, I just give this name a post check. Let it be finished. And also, I can see that this file should be created here. Yes, this file is created. And the user who created this is root. Now, how to restore it? So let's assume that our etcd data directory is corrupted. In this case, we can restore the snapshot. Data directory is the directory where all etcd configuration and data files are present. How we can find the etcd data directory? This is the command that here I'm going to open again YAML file and then grep data dir. Let me copy here and then paste it over here. This is my data directory. Let's check this data directory. See, D stands for directory. And the user is root. Or we can execute this kubectl describe command and then grab data dir. I should observe the same output here. ls space ld etcd that I did already here. Let's do it again. This is created by root user. This time we are going to create a new directory. Thus, we will use data dir equal to varlib etcd backup. This is my new directory we will going to create inside this varlib. We can use directory name. Good thing is that we have all already knows the endpoint, CA cert, cert and key files right here, all these things. In the previous command, snapshot save, but for restore, I'm use restore option. And in the end, we are going to inform that data dir is this. It means that this restore will create one new directory, this directory, and restore all the files inside this directory here. I will show you in a couple of minutes. Let me execute this command here. and it says created here. Var lib etcd backup, and inside this there are multiple directories created here. Let me scroll up. Let me show you here. You see member is here, and if I use member, I will observe multiple directories inside this. It means that this resource will create a new directory, and beneath this directory it copied or created multiple directories. Now if I execute previous command, this directory and the new directory that we created now in my environment, it is showing root. It means that there will be no permission issue will be observed, but in exam you will observe that this is created by etcd. So you need to update the directory, and you need to execute ch on change ownership minus capital R means recursive etcd etcd if the user is created by etcd etcd. If you need to observe the previous var lib etcd directory, what user it is here, same username and group name you need to define here and then here. For now I don't need to require, because I have already, because etcd user is not created in my environment and the users are same here. Let's check. I should see only one pod. Post pod is still there. Why? Because we haven't modified the etcd YAML file, static pod YAML file. Why we are observing two pods? We have restored the snapshot, but etcd static pod YAML file data dir is still the old one. Let's confirm it. It's still var lib etcd. In this file, if I copy var lib etcd, if I grab this, I will observe that in this file there is three entries: mount path and path. It means that volume I need to update also. Either I can open this file with the help of vi editor like this and search for etcd, this one, and I observe multiple things here. So data dir is here, var lib etcd. First I need to update this one, and then in the volume mount path and then path. If I scroll down here, path here, this is I also need to update. The easiest way is that we can use the sed command. Let me show you here. Sed minus I is for insert, S is for substitute, and equal is the sign. And after that I use this var lib etcd only, and then equal to the next variable I want to update here. It means that it will substitute this to this. For which file? This file. Okay, let me copy and paste it over here. Now again, if I check the same command, now I will observe that etcd backup directory is updated here. Okay, if I execute this command kubectl get pod, it takes some time. Why? Because my etcd pod is restarting. Let's wait for 5 minutes. I believe that it takes 5 minutes. Now I am observing one error message here. Let's check with this again. Now in my case it is showing pending. If this is the case for you also, then you can perform the other steps. Here I'm going to capture all the YAML file output in one file. Okay, and now I'm going to delete this etcd pod here. I'm not sure why it is happening, but yes, it's happened with me. So I just created this pod and then again create the same pod with same YAML file here. And if you are stuck here, then you can control C and then --force iPhone, iPhone 4 is enough. I believe that yes, now it is deleted here. We can check kubectl get pods minus capital A. Now I will not observe this etcd, right? Let me create this again, kubectl apply minus f etc dot yaml file. Now it is created here. Let's wait for some time. It is showing pending here, or we can use grep etc. Now after deleting this pod forcefully and the grace period is zero, it is showing running here. If I use kubectl get pods, I will observe only one pod is running. It means that we have successfully created the etcd snapshot, and after that we created one pod and then restore it. Obviously that pod is not inside this etcd backup, so that pod is not showing me here. How I can clear the lab here? I just copied here, and here you will observe that varlib etcd directory. I'm going to delete here and then going to restore again what we have, this snapshot.db, and the data directory will be varlib etcd, so that we can perform the second lab with the same directory, and then going to delete this pod and then change. This time I'm using this etcd backup to this etcd, and then delete all the files here. A single command will do everything for you. Everything is removed here. So let's check kubectl get pod. I should not see a single pod here. Maybe it takes some time because my etcd is again in pending mode, I guess. Let's check if this is the case or not. But yes, when we restore it, it takes some time. Let's wait for a couple of more minutes. Once it's done, then we will move to the second lab. Now it is running here. Kubectl, the one pod is running still, right? So I can delete this pod here. Kubectl delete pod precheck. Okay, it is finished now. Lab 2 is already done at the beginning. So let's jump into lab number 3. Lab. And here in this question, create a snapshot for existing etcd instance which are running on local IP address and the port number is 2379. Saving the snapshot to here. Below you can use. In this question, it is provided you all the CACRT files and etcd, everything it is provided. In this scenario, you don't need to go to the static port YAML file, or you don't need to require to describe the etcd port. You can create your command. If you go here, you will observe that CACRT file is here. You can use CACERT file is this, and then server cert file is this, cover server key file is this one. If in exam, if the question ask you like this, it will be more easy for you, and follow the rest of the other steps what we had performed on lab number 2. That's it. If you like my video and want to help me indirectly or directly, then you can use my PayPal account, that is paypal.me/anisharna2001. This is my PayPal account. In the GitHub page, I have already uploaded the etcd snapshot and restore process PPT, and in the thumbnail you will observe that how to take the snapshot, and in the restore I will use snapshot restore command. Thank you very much. Have a good day to you. Bye bye.